Today, this presentation is about the sociology of law under the subject Introduction to Criminology. First, what is sociology of law? It defined as the division of criminology which attempt to offer scientific analysis of the conditions under which penal or criminal laws are developed. The process of formal social control. So the sociology of law concerned with the making of laws. Then a concept of law and its origin. So in general sense, law defined as the science of moral laws based on the rational nature of man, which governs his free activity for the realization of his individual and social ends. So the law sets the limits to the behavior and action of people in a society. And then specifically, law defined as a rule of conduct, just and obligatory, promulgated by legitimate authority of common observance and benefit. So the law created by the authority for the common good of the society. Then historically, it was the Babylonians and the Hebrews and later the Romans who first recognized the concept of law and crime. So let's go to the history. Number one, we have the Code of Hammurabi. The Code of Hammurabi was adapted from the Sumerian codes. And this legal system was based on the physical retaliation or lex talionis, and also famous with the term an eye for an eye. Second, we have the Mosaic Code. According to tradition, God entered into a covenant or contract with the tribes of Israel in which they agreed to obey his law as presented to them by Moses in return for God's special care and protection for Israel. Third, we have the 12 tables. The 12 tables formulated by the 10 noble Roman men. It is created as a response to pressure the or control the lower class, which were referred as the plebeians. And later, Emperor Justin of Rome appointed 12 experts to review the law of the 12 tables. And it was took effect in 529 AD. Which was later known as the Justinian Code. Then number four, we have the common law. The common law was based on judge decisions because judges would decide cases and future cases would be decided based on those previous decisions by the judge. This system known as the stare decisi, which is a Latin, which means to stand by decided cases. So that is the concept of common law. It was exercised during the regime of King Henry II in England. Let's proceed to the classification of law. So broadly, we have two classification of law, namely the substantive law and the civil law. The substantive law has been defined as the part of the law which creates, defines, and regulates the rights, or which regulates the rights and duties which give rise to the cause of action. So example ng substantive law is the criminal law. And next, we have the civil law. The civil law was created especially for the protection of private interests. So that is the civil law. Then we have the types of law. Number one, the natural law. Natural law are rooted in core values by many cultures. Natural laws protect against harm to persons or property and form basis of common law systems. That's the natural law. Next, we have the statutory law. Are those enacted by legislatures and reflect current cultural mores, albeit that some laws may be controversial, example the laws that prohibit marijuana use and gambling. So the statutory law, also known as the mala prohibita, or the crimes of mala prohibita, which were they are wrong because there is a law. While on the other hand, the natural law, they are wrong from their very nature, or also known as the crime mala in se. Then accordingly, we have also the divine law, the law of the supreme being, or the law of God. Next, we have the types and definition of crime. So crime defined as an act or omission punishable by law forbidding or commanding it. So we have the Latin maxim, nullum crimen, nulla pena sine lege, which means there is no crime when there is no law punishing it. And also the term crime is a generic term for the felony, offense, infraction, and delinquency. So technically, under the Philippine system, felony refers to the acts or omissions in violation to the revised penal code. While offense, those are in violation to the special laws. And then what are the difference between the crime mala in se and crime mala prohibita? So the crime mala in se, they are wrong from their beginning or from their nature. They are against under the provisions of the revised penal code. While on the other hand, the crime mala prohibita refers generally to acts made criminal by special laws. So the crime mala prohibita originally are not evil, but because of the observance of the common good of the society, the authority made them criminal. Those are crime mala prohibita. Next, we have the elements of crime. So under the criminological concept, we have the motive, opportunity, and instrumentality. Let's start with the opportunity. That refers to the chance or time of the offender to execute a crime. That is opportunity. Next, we have the instrumentality or capability. Instrumentality refers to the use of materials or any means in the commission of crime, while capability refers to the ability or the physical capability of a person to perpetrate a crime. So motive refers to the moving power which compels one to act for a definite result. So motive, ito yung tinatawag nating reason or the dahilan ng offender kung bakit niya ginawa yung crime. Example, jealousy, then revenge. And accordingly, intent refers to the purpose of a particular means to effect such result. So intent naman, ito yung paraan kung paano mo i-execute ang isang crime. Example, pagpatay or pagnanakaw. those are intent. So in the legal setting, motive is not an element of crime because in motive, wala ka pang crime na nagagawa. For example, in motive, let's say, nagselos ka or naiingit ka. So kapag ikaw ay nagselos o kaya naman ay naiingit, wala ka pang crime na nakokommit or wala ka pang law na nababiolate kasi wala naman crime or wala naman batas na nagpapanis sa pagkaingit or pagselos. While intent naman, dito na na-determine yung crime na ginawa mo. Of course, the actions or means na ginawa ng isang person na masasabi natin nakakomit siya ng crime. Example nga yung pagpatay or pagnakaw. So, in legal concept, those are the elements of crime, the intent, opportunity, and instrumentality. Next, we have the classification of crime. Number one, the blue collar crime is any crime committed by individual from a lower class, blue collar crime, as opposed to the white collar crime, those committed by individuals of higher social class. Next, we have the corporate crime, refers to crimes committed either by a corporation or by individuals that may be identified with the corporation or other business entity. So kapag may involved na corporation or business, that is called a corporate crime. Next, we have the organized crime or the criminal organizations. In organized crime, committed by a group of persons run by criminals, most commonly for the purpose of monetary profit or for the purpose of monetary gain. That is organized crime. Next, political crime naman, involving acts or omissions where the in which prejudice the interests of the state and also the government and the political system. Example ng political crime ay treason, sedition, and terrorism. Wherein yung na-compromise yung security ng state or ng government. That is political crime. Public order crime naman refers to crime which involves acts that interfere with the operations of society. So kapag merong actions, masasabi natin na nag-i-interfere sa normal function ng society, that is a public order crime. Next, we have the state crime. State crime is activity or failure to act that break the state's own criminal law or the public international law. Number seven, the state corporate crime. The concept of state corporate crime or incorporated governance refers to crimes that resulted from the relationship between the policy of the state and the policies and practices of commercial corporations. Number eight, we have the white collar crime. Within the field of criminology, white collar crime has been defined by Sutherland as a crime committed by a person of respectability and in social status in the course of his occupation. Number nine, we have the victimless crime. Victimless crime is a behavior of an individual which is forbidden by law, but which neither violates nor significantly threatens the rights of other persons or individuals. So under the victimless crime, the victim is also the accused. And in common usage, victimless crime refers to behavior that is illegal, but it is claimed to not violate the rights of the other or anyone. except the person or the accused itself. Kumbaga, yung individual yung last crime, yung biktima ay yung suspect, biktima niya rin yung kanyang sarili. Example, ito use of illegal drugs. And then, victimless crime is known today as a public order crime. Then, reasons why members of society be interested in crimes. Number one, because crime is pervasive, meaning it affects almost all the people in society. That's pervasive. Second, crime is expensive because the government spend an enormous amount of money for the crime detection, prosecution, correction, and prevention of crime. So we have the direct expenses and indirect expenses. When we talk about direct expenses, those spent by government or private sector for the maintenance or the police and security guards for crime detection, prosecution, and judiciary support of prison systems. So indirect naman, those expenses used to prevent the commission of crimes. Number three, crime is destructive because crime many lives and properties may have been lost or destroyed. That's why crime is destructive. Then crime is reflective. The crime rate or incidence in a given locality is reflective of the effectiveness of the social offenses or defenses employed by the people, primarily of the police system. So, meaning, kung gaano ka prevalent yung crime sa isang locality, magre-reflect yun sa kanilang police system kung gaano ito ka-effective. Number five, crime is progressive. So, as the population increases, the crime may tend to and increase also. Then crime and criminal law. Then a crime, once again, any act or omission in violation of public law forbidding or commanding it. That is crime. Then a criminal law naman is the branch of division of law which defines crime, traits of their nature, and provides a punishment. Criminal law natin sa Pilipinas, yung revised penal code. And then here are the sources of criminal law. Number one, we have the RPC, or known as the Act Number 3815. And also we have the special penal laws and the penal presidential decrees. Now let's move to the characteristics of criminal law. So the criminal law has three characteristics. We have the generality, wherein the criminal law is binding on all persons who live or sojourn in the Philippine territory. Meaning, yung criminal law ay applicable sa lahat ng taong nangirahan sa Philippine territory. But of course, there is exemptions. Second, we have the territoriality, wherein the criminal laws undertake to punish all crimes committed under the Philippine territory. And with the exceptions provided within the Article 2 of the Revised Penal Code. And then third, we have the prospectivity of criminal law, wherein its concept is that you cannot make an act punishable in a manner wherein they are not punishable at the time of their commission. Ibig sabihin, hindi mo pwedeng parusahan ng isang tao sa kanyang nagawang sa kanyang actions na kung saan wala namang nagpaparusa or batas na babawal dun sa kanyang action. So, yun po yung characteristics ng criminal law, generality, territoriality, and prospectivity. Then we have the history of the revised penal code. The revised penal code was a revision of the old penal code, which became effective in the Philippines. Itong old penal code on July 14, 1887 and was enforced up to December 31, 1931. So itong old penal code ay na-revise. Siyempre, andito na yung revised penal code. Was revised through the committee, which was created by Administrative Order Number 94 of the Department of Justice. So the committee consisted of Anacleto Diaz as the chairman, including its members Quintin Paredes, Guillermo Guevara, Alex Reyes, and Mariano de Hoya. So the revised penal code took effect in the Philippines on January 1, 1932. Then a brief history of Philippine criminal law. So before the promulgation of Code of Calancha in 1433, the people of the pre-Spanish period had the customary unwritten laws. Some of them are due respect to elders and parents, strict obedience of children, their parents, and strict fulfillment of contract, and also the equality of husband and wife. And later on, when the Code of Calancha was promulgated in 1433, these are some of the punishments that were being practiced. We have the death, incineration, or the burning, and mutilation of fingers, slavery, pangalipin, then flagellation, or the whipping, then being beaten by ants. And also we have the swimming under the water for a long period of time and other disciplinary penalties. Here are some of the significant attributes of the Code of Calanchao. So we have the you shall not kill or not steal or hurt the aged. So let's proceed to the felony. A felony is an act or omission punishable by a special revised penal code. It is punishable specifically by the RPC. So the felony may be committed by two means. Number one, by means of fault or culpa. And then number two, by means of dolo or deceit. So literally, by means of intentional and unintentional felony. And then note, all felonies are crimes, but not all crimes are felonies because it could be also be an offense or misdemeanor. Let's go to the classification of felonies as to the manner of commission. We have the intentional felony and culpable felony. Intentional felony is done by with deliberate intent. So there are the requisites. The offender has a freedom, and also he has intelligence. And ginawa niya yung crime with a deliberate intent. So that is an intentional felony. Number two, we have the culpable felony, wherein the wrongful act resulted from the imprudence or the deficiency of action, aka lack of skill, and by means of negligence or the deficiency of perception or the lack of foresight. So here are the requisites of the culpable felony. The offender has freedom, and also he has the intelligence, but despite of it, he done the wrongful act by means of imprudence or negligence. Imprudence means lack of skill, and then negligence naman, lack of foresight. So these are the two manner of commission of felony: the intentional felony and culpable felony. And then a classification of crime as to the stages of its commission. We have the attempted crime, wherein the offender commences the felony directly by overt acts. However, does not perform all the acts which would produce the felony. And also, under the attempted crime or attempted stage, his acts are not stopped by his own spontaneous desistance. Ibig sabihin, hindi nagawang perform ng offender or ng suspect yung krimen dahil due to this situation. Ibig sabihin, hindi niya, he's not voluntarily desist in committing crime or in attempting to commit a crime. Second, we have the prostrated crime. The offender performs all the acts of execution. All these acts would produce the felony as a consequence. But the felony is not produced by reason of causes independent of the will of the perpetrator. So this is a prostrated stage. Na-exercise or na-execute ng perpetrator yung kanyang criminal action. However, yung purpose niya, hindi niya na-achieve. Yun yung frustrated crime. Then consummated crime naman, all the elements necessary for its execution and accomplishment are present. Consummated, ibig sabihin na-achieve ng perpetrator yung kanyang purpose. Let's proceed to the plurality of crimes or the classification of crimes as to the plurality. One, we have the simple crime, wherein a single act constitutes only one offense. While on the other hand, complex crime, a single act constitutes two or more grave or less grave felony. That is a compound crime. Don't be confused, it is a compound crime wherein the single act constitute two or more grave or less grave felony. While on the other hand, complex crime proper naman, when an offense is a necessary means for committing the other offense. Complex crime proper. So, compound crime and complex crime proper are under the complex crime. Next, we have the classification as to the gravity of penalty. We have the grievance. When the law attaches the capital punishment and afflictive penalties, those are grave felonies, or a fine which exceeds 6,000. It is before the implementation of the RA 10951. Actually, of the less grave felonies, which are punishable with the correctional penalties. And then light felonies, which are when the law attaches with the arresto minor, or the 1 day to 30 days imprisonment. And take note, under the provision of the RA 10951, which was took effect on August 31, 2017, a crime considered a grave felony if the law or the fine exceeds 1,200,000, yung fine na charge. And then less grave naman, if it does not exceed 1,200,000, but is not less than 40,000 pesos, less grave. And then a light felonies naman, if the fine attached is less than 40,000 pesos. That is according to the provision of RA 10951. Next, we have the criminological classification of crimes as to the result of crimes. So crime is, according to its result, it may be acquisitive crime or extinctive. Acquisitive, when the offender acquires something as a consequence of his criminal action. This commonly in a theft or robbery. Extinctive crime naman, when the result of the criminal act is destructive. Next, as to the time or period of commission, we have seasonal and situational. Seasonal crime, those are committed only during the certain period of the year, like the violation of tax law or also the violation of the election law. Situational crime naman, those committed only when given the situation conducive to its commission, situational crime. Also, we have the classification of crime as to the length of time of commission. We have the instant crime committed in the shortest possible time. Also, we have the episodic crime, those committed by a series of acts in a lengthy space of time. So that's all for today. Thank you for listening, and God bless everyone.